solid food. That's the challenge with children. Children, apart from playing with them, they can't eat solid food. 1 Peter 2:2, he says that, like infants at the breast, drink God's pure kindness. Then you will grow. Give me King James. King James says that as newborn babies, desire the sincere milk of the word, that you may grow thereby. So children take milk. Look at your neighbor and say, children,
children
take milk. Shake your neighbor violently and say, children,
take milk.
Do you know that among all animals, it's only human beings that don't take milk when they are old? Say mercy. When the cow grows, it's not taking milk. It's not chewing grass. You give the cow some milk again, don't drink. When the goat grows, it no longer drinks milk, it now begins to take grass. Human beings, when they grow, they move from breast milk to ideal milk. But it is time to stop taking milk.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
Yes, it is time to stop taking milk. Hebrews chapter 5 verse 12 says that, for at the time that you ought to be teachers, you still have need that one should teach you again the first principles of the oracles of God. And become such as have need of milk. When I come to you, I'm talking about basic things like walking in purity and all of those things. These are the first principles, the fundamentals. But some of you have been in the church, we still have to talk about this over and over and over again. Because you didn't change when you heard the first time. At the time you want to be teachers, yet here I find you like someone who needs to sit down with you and go over the basics of God again. Starting from square one, baby's milk. When you should have been on solid food long ago. Abba. Milk is for babies. Look at the verse 13. Give me King James for verse 13. Verse 13. He says that for everyone. No, 13 says milk is for beginners, inexperienced in God's ways. I want King James for this verse 13. Everyone that uses milk is unskillful. He says that milk, everyone that partakes only of milk is unskillful in the word of righteousness because he's a babe, he's a nephew. Who are you calling babe? I don't know who taught you that, but you know, the Bible says you are daughters of Sarah. And like Sarah, who called Abraham Lord, 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 Lord. So you see, but if men, women, the godly women of old, they call their husbands Lord. In our day, we have converted them to babes.